Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started video on how to add the Blazor tab component of Syncfusion to a Blazor server app. Just imagine that you are going to design a web page to show multiple contents in a compact space one at a time. To design this scenario, you can make use of the Blazor tab component of Syncfusion that comes with a rich set of features like different header styles, animations, orientation modes, nested tabs, as well as a scrollable or pop-up tab when there are more tabs. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how to add the Blazor tab component to a Blazor server app using Visual Studio 2019. First, I will start with the Blazor application creation process. For that, I need to make sure whether .NET Core SDK latest version is installed in my machine, and I should have Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019 to create a Blazor application. In this tutorial, I'm going to create a new server-side Blazor app. So, let me open the Visual Studio 2019 first and create a new project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I will choose Blazor app and click Next to proceed further with the project creation. Here, I will name my project as Blazor example and click the Create button. Next, I will choose this Blazor server app option and click this Create button finally to complete the project creation. Now, the project has been created and ready to use. If you want to know more about the Blazor server app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, then you can listen to the video link that is shown in the above YouTube card. Now, I will tell you the steps to add the Blazor tab component. Before I start to use the Blazor tab component, first I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor NuGet package into my application. For that, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choose the option Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I will search for Syncfusion Blazor in the Browse tab and install it into my project. Once the installation gets completed, let me navigate to imports.razor file, and here I will add Syncfusion Blazor navigations namespace to start using the Blazor tab in any of the components available under the pages folder. Next, I will open the startup.cs file, and here I will add Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then I will register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling a method addSyncfusionBlazor within the configure services method. Also, I should register the valid license key into my application. So, let me register the trial license key using the register license method. The next important thing is I need to define the CSS for tab control. Therefore, let me navigate to host.cshtml file under the pages folder to refer the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Now, everything is configured, so let me start to add the Blazor tab component. For that, I need to open the index.razor component, and here I will remove the default code and include SF tab component. Then, I need to add the tab items tag to define the number of items to be displayed within this tab component. This tab items property is of type array, so I can add n number of tab item definitions inside it. Here, I'm going to display information about two different programming languages. So, let me define two tab item tags within this tab items tag. For these tabs, I need to set the tab name, therefore, I will define tab header tag inside the child content tag. Then, I will define the property text and set appropriate string values to it. Also, within this tab item tag, I need to define the property content and assign the tab content to it to display them inside the tab. Also, to align the tab content, I will define the property CSS class to override view CSS class here. Now, I'm going to run this example. So here, You can see the output page. The tab component shows two different tabs. Suppose if I would like to change the tab header position to display either at the bottom, left or right, then I may need to use the property header placement. Now I'm going to display the tab header at the left. So let me define the property header placement and set its header position as left. See the output page now. The tab header items are placed at the left side of the tab. In case, if I want to place the tab header items at the right side of the tab, then I need to set the header position as right. So here, you can see the tab component. The tab header items are placed at the right side of the tab. Suppose, if I want to display the tab header at the bottom of the tab, then I need to set the tab header position as bottom. And now, you can see the tab component. The tab header items are placed at the bottom of the tab. By default, you can see no style is applied to the tab header. In case, if you want to apply specific style for these tab headers, then you can set either predefined or custom classes to the tab root element. The available predefined classes are efill, eBackground and eBackground eAccent. Here, I have planned to set background color for active tab header. So, let me assign predefined class efill to CSS class property so that the tab headers will be highlighted with background color. And now, you can see the tab component. The active tab header is displayed with background color like this. So far I have shown you how to add the tab content using the content property, but now let me proceed to show you how to add content for tabs by using the template. For that, first I need to define another tab item tag with header text. To add content, I'm going to use HTML elements here. Therefore, I will define content template tag inside the tab item. Then, within this content template tag, I will define a div element and add appropriate content to it. Look at the output page now. The tab component rendered with three headers like HTML, Java, and JavaScript. Suppose if you want to display more tab items in the tab component, then there is a chance that the tab header items will overflow from the default available space. In this scenario, you may need to specify the appropriate tab display mode. By default, the tab component displays its overflowing tab items in the scrollable mode when you add more tabs. So now, let me proceed to show you how the tab items are displayed in the scrollable overflow mode. To show you the working of this default scrollable mode, first I will define the width property. And then, I will add 10 more additional items to the tab component. Now, I'm going to place the tab header at the top, so I will set the tab header position as top. When you look at the output page now, the tab header items will get displayed in a single line with horizontal scrolling enabled at both the end to move back and forth between the tab items. In case, if I want to display those overflowing tab items in a pop-up, then I need to define the property overflow mode and set its value as pop-up. So here, you can see the tab component. When I click the down arrow, the overflowing tab header items will be moved to the pop-up container like this. Now, let me proceed to show you how the two-way binding works with the tab control, for which I need to make use of the property selected item. To make it simple, I will retain only 4 of the tab items and remove other items from here. Now, I'm going to show you how the tab dynamically changes its selected tab item value based on the value change that happens in the numeric text box and vice versa. So, to add the numeric text box, first I need to open the imports.razor file and import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor inputs. Then, I will define numeric text box control with the properties tValue, min, max, and width. By default, the properties with the prefix bind attribute denotes that it supports two-way binding across the Blazor components. Here, the selected item property of tab and value property of numeric text box supports two-way binding. So, first I am planning to set default value as 0 to both of these components. For that, I will define a variable changed value of type double and set its value as 0. Then, within this numeric text box code, I will define the property bind value and assign the changed value variable to it. And to the tab control, I will define the property bind selected item and assign the same variable changed value. So here, you can see the output page. When I change the numeric value in text box, say 2, the corresponding tab item at that index position 3 gets opened in the tab. Similarly, when I select the second tab, the numeric text box value is automatically changed to 1. In this way, the two-way binding works perfectly with the tab component. Now, let me make a quick summary of what we have seen so far. We have seen how to create a Blazor project using Visual Studio 2019 and added a Syncfusion Blazor tab component in the server app. Also, we have seen how to change the tab header position as well as how to set styles to the active tab header. Finally, we have also seen how to add contents using template and how to set display mode to the tab component. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link which I have shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting free license key to use our complete Blazor products if you fit into our community license guidelines. So, check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using our community license. Also, if you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.